Hyperextension of the knee, whether due to injury or disorder, is often the cause of back knee instability reported by patients. Treating this issue, however, can be challenging. One reason why is that it is currently unclear which structures in the knee contribute most to hyperextension, or rather, which structures work hardest to prevent it. A new study published in the American Journal of Sports Medicine suggests that while no single compartment serves as a primary restraint to hyperextension, the posteromedial and posterolateral capsular structures provide major resistance, with the cruciate ligaments also providing some but less resistance. Researchers reached those conclusions by testing 24 knees from human cadavers. A 6-degree of freedom robotic system was used to place the knees in hyperextension through one of two methods, static loading or cyclic loading. In the static loading method, knees were hyperextended to the same level of torque. Selected soft tissue structures were then cut from the knees in sequence, with the resulting loss in restraining moment representing the function of each structure in resisting hyperextension. In the cyclic loading method, the setup was the same, except that tissues were cut only after bringing the knee to its resting state. This allowed researchers to capture any possible stress relaxation that tissues in the knee may undergo. Results showed that the posterior structures of the knee provided more than half the total resistance to hyperextension. These included the posteromedial capsule and posterior oblique ligament, the fibrofibular ligament and posterolateral capsule, and the oblique popliteal ligament. The next biggest contributors to total resistance were the cruciate ligaments, followed by medial and lateral structures. While the findings are limited to a single form of simulated hyperextension and were gathered from a small sample of knees, they do offer a consistent message. Surgical correction of abnormal knee hyperextension may involve multiple ligament and soft tissue structures, requiring clinicians to look beyond any single contributing factor.